What you just saw is a recreation of an asteroid hitting the Earth. If the asteroid were the size of a pea, and it was slamming into a tiny piece of the Earth. It also shows a surprising way huge amounts of water could have reached our planet. That's important. Earth has a lot of water. About 70% of its surface is covered with it. Where did it come from? There are different ideas about how to account for Earth's water. It could have been here from the start, or arrived via comets or interplanetary dust. And then there are asteroids. Unlike comets, that are essentially frozen dust balls, asteroids carry molecules of water bound up with their rock. 4+ billion years ago, the Earth was pummeled by asteroids in a time called the Late Bombardment. It was thought that the water in the asteroids would be lost during the intense heat of the impacts, but that may not be so. Scientists used NASA's vertical gun, an apparatus 3 stories high, to mimic the process with much, much smaller objects. They shot a pea-sized bit of rock called antigerite, composed partly of water, into a tiny bit of pumice with no water. The tiny rock projectile only goes about 10 feet, but at more than 11,000 miles per hour. Scientists found that despite extreme temperatures on impact, up to 30% of the pebble asteroid's water was trapped in melted rock. As the stand-in asteroid made contact, the pumice melted and fused together with tiny bits of the projectile in a substance called breccia. Vaporized water molecules were trapped in the breccia, some of which you can see here. For real asteroids hitting the Earth, that could be a lot of water, and it could be released later, for example, in steam from lava flows. So, asteroids could conceivably have delivered enormous amounts of water to the planet and helped make life on Earth possible. Hello, YouTube. I'm Jim Gorman, the host of ScienceTake, the show you just saw. If you don't mind snakes and you're not squeamish and you're curious about science, subscribe to the channel below.